Hey everybody, this is Al Robinson here. I just got back in from my long drive from Memphis, Tennessee. Well, not really long. It's about the same time you get to Chicago. But it was a good drive from Memphis, Tennessee from Anime Blues Con, which was my first time there. So to wrap things up, Friday was a good day. Got in about an hour ahead of schedule. Usually that's about maybe a 5-hour drive, but I drove a little bit faster. Usually, whenever I'm on a highway, I drive the speed limit. So if it's 70, I'm driving 70. Or if it's like a 60-mile-an-hour high drive, I'll usually drive like 65 or so. Just, you know, five over is usually my limit. But this time, I drove 75, so I got there a little bit faster and a little bit earlier than I was anticipating. But I made it there Friday. Mostly I kind of walked around a little bit and took in a couple of panels, actually. There was a panel on, I'm sorry, my memory's a little jogged. It was long drive, so, I can't remember a lot of the panels that I went to, that afternoon, but, I went to the, iShine concert that night. If you're not familiar with iShine, that's actually Johnny Ong Bosch's band. If you remember Adam from Power Rangers, yeah, he's actually in the band now, aside from doing voiceovers. So his band is awesome. I definitely recommend them. iShine.net, I believe. I'll have a link post. The website's down here. So, yeah, definitely check them out. If you like good rock and music, they're definitely the band to check out. Saturday was, you know, the big day. You know, we were rushing around, you know, there's a lot of panels taken. There was a pony panel that I went to. I was planning on going to that, and it was pretty fun, you know. Cosplay contest. I did a video on that, and it's on my YouTube, so I'm gonna post that one immediately after I get through posting this one. But I enjoyed it. It was really good. I saw some really interesting cosplays. There was a really good Vivi from Final Fantasy IX there. That one actually took, like, the overall badassness award. The overall best in show award. I'm really happy about that because that was really well done. And, like, when you look at it in the video, you'll see that it's really well done. But, yeah, the cosplay contest was awesome. You know, if you guys were keeping up on my Facebook, I had mentioned something about a fire hazard that took place, and I was saying that, like, some dumbass kid had tripped the fire alarm. But actually, I've been hearing a lot of things like, you know, there actually was a fire in the hotel, like in a rave. Someone actually set some kind of fire in a rave. I can't really say it for sure if that's the truth, but yeah. We were out there for a good, I want to say, good 45 minutes to an hour. I don't know. I was actually out on a food run when that actually took place. I had gotten back and just walked to the hotel, and the fire alarms were, like, blazing like crazy. And, like, everybody was just filing outside of the hotel, and the Memphis Fire Department brought in, like, five fire trucks, five big reds to the hotel to, like, you know, front. And then, like, they let us back in for a little bit, but then they said, nope, go back out. And we went back out, we just waited for a little while longer. And other than that, it was nice. There were a couple of adult things actually went on there too. Like, there was a strip show that took place on Friday, and it was a rather tame one, I should say. There were strippers of both genders. They had four female strippers and two male strippers, which, like, stole the show at that one. It was fun to look at. Like, if you were a female there, you know, you'd be going crazy at those two male strippers. They were actually really good dancers there. Okay, yeah, the strip show was Friday night, and then Saturday night was a pajama party. Then there was another sort of a strip show. It was a cosplay off thing. And is, you know, they're in cosplay, and then they take the cosplay off to, like, you know, dance music and whatnot. But I actually caught, like, the last few minutes of that because I was kind of recovering from climbing all the way up to the 19th floor, which is where my room was. So yeah, that was fun. But I didn't stay too long on Sunday. I stayed till about 1 and then decided to drive back. There really wasn't much going on. They had like an anime idol thing, which is like American Idol except set to anime, that some guy won. I didn't really look at a lot of it, but Sunday wasn't too bad. It was a really neat con. This time around, I didn't really take a lot of pictures like I wanted to. I didn't really see a lot of cosplays there that I thought were very spectacular, so I decided to, like, I had my camera with me the whole time. I just didn't really see anything that was, like, picture-worthy. So I just said, not this time. I'll save it for MechaCon. Or NatsuCon, which is coming up in August. So, yeah, I didn't really buy a lot either. I was kind of like on a tight budget this time, so I decided like to cut back on a lot, but it just like limit myself to food and gas on this trip, along with a hotel room. But I did buy a couple of things. Just give me a minute. This one is going to go along with a brand new cosplay that I am going to start to put together. And, don't be alarmed, it's a pony cosplay. Yeah. Who would have thought my very first cosplay would be a pony cosplay? But, I'm gonna make it work. I'm gonna try my best to make it work. So, just to show off one thing that I did buy, as a set of, wings. I bought these at the Artist Alley section from a really very cool wing. Well, I don't think I should say just wing designer, but like a really good designer who like made a ton of these wings, like in different sizes, different shapes. You know, she worked real hard on these things, and I wore these for a good majority of the con that I actually had them. These only cost me like $35, so they really weren't that expensive at all. And I think like the large wings that she did have, those actually ran for about $60 or $70 or so. I can't remember offhand. But, I love these. And I'm going to try to put together some sort of a Rainbow Dash cosplay with the pony hat that I already have that I bought from Anime St. Louis. And, with these, we're going to add a little more. All I really need to do now is just find a rainbow tail. And, I can just use whatever shirt that I want, or like, maybe buy a cerulean blue shirt or something like that. But yeah, this is one thing. Really proud of these. And you will see, if you go to a con, you will see me wearing those. So just letting you know. And the only other thing that I bought from this con is a mystery box. This is a mystery grab box that I bought for like $10. So it's got like a whole bunch of stuff in here. That I have not yet opened this. As you can see the tape is still on it. So I decided not to open this until I got back home. So what the contents of what's in here is a mystery to me. So we're just gonna open this together and see what's inside. So I got my blade, I got the box, we're gonna cut this open and find out what's inside. I don't know if you can hear it, but the unit's outside. She wants to come in, but she's not coming in. I'm not going to let her in here because there's stuff in here, and I kind of have to tidy up in here. But the box. Okay. Interesting. Okay, so I have a Star Wars card in here. I actually got something on the back. Oh, this is a Comic-Con. This is a San Diego Comic-Con card that actually has where some of the stuff. Oh, wait. This is actually from 2003. I don't know if you can see. Yeah, you can see it now. It's from 2003. A Comic-Con card. A couple of JOAJSA card. A Batman bookmark. Nice. A couple of promo cards for, Atlanta Comic Con. I can't see what year this is. I also have one for a Knoxville Comic and Anime Con. And this was from last year. Ah, computer went to sleep on me. Wake up, MacBook. okay, this one. Okay, these are both for 2012. I just found a thing for it. Full Metal Alchemist card, promo card, I believe, for one of the movies. A little brain toy. How about that? Here's something interesting. Paul of Dune book. The sci-fi book. Something that was on the Sci-Fi Channel. I'm gonna try to give this a read. This kind of looks interesting. Okay, what have we got? Plastic. Little kitty keychain, which for me, because I'm a cat person. Some more toys in here. Ooh, something's rolled. I got something here that's rolled up. Let me get my knife back out. Find out what this is. Crap, I ripped it. Oh, well. It looks like artwork that I unfortunately just ruined. Well, actually, it's a Spider-Man 3 poster. And I don't really feel so bad about it because I didn't like Spider-Man 3. Hated that movie to death. Okay, so there's a couple of more toys in here. So, a couple more toys can balloon. Ah, it's got some comic books. What have I got? I have X-Factor, Return of Mesmero, and what issue is this? Looks X-Factor number 55. Fresh inside the cover. That might be a collector's. What else? Damage Beginning of Tomorrow. What issue is? Issue number 0. I don't know. It's still in the bag, too. This might actually be worth something. I don't know. The Max, number 5. Not B. Ah, I did it again. Wake up, MacBook. Wake the blazes up. What else? Ninja High School, number 11. I have no idea what this is about. I don't know if I really want to take this out of the thing. Ooh. How about this? I don't know if you can see it. Uruse Yatsu, Return of Lum. This ought to be interesting. I might want to take this out and read it. Got an Inuyasha comic. This is Inuyasha number 5, part 3. Do I really want to take this out and look at it? I don't know. I'll see. I'm not sure. Dracoon. At least I think. Yeah, Dracoon the Hidden War. One of 6. This is issue number 1. Looks interesting. Might be. I might take this out and read it. Is this a magazine? I believe it is. Dreamwatch magazine. Best in sci-fi and fiction. This actually has like an ode to Deep Space Nine. So, that's kind of a nice grab, I think. And lastly, that I actually want to pull out of here because there's a lot of other junk in here, is this Aliens, I believe it's a graphic novel. Yeah, it's a graphic novel. It's like a graphic novel magazine or so. Aliens Holy War, Volume 2, Number 13. I might actually give this a read. So, yeah, that's all. That's aside from the mini junk that I've got in here that's like kind of, not really much to bring about. But other than that was it. That is the contents of the grab box. I got some pretty interesting things, I gotta say. Got some junk, some interesting things. Yeah. So at any rate, that's gonna wrap things up for me. I'm kind of tired, so I'm just gonna go lie down for a little bit. And yeah, I will see you guys next week. Oh, one more thing I should say. I'm gonna reiterate this. I did post it on my Facebook that I said, but I'm gonna say this in this here. Next month I will not be attending any cons. I kind of need next month to take care of a couple of minor financial issues that come up. So because, like, as many of you know, I got promoted at work, and I got a raise, so I'm going to try to take as much advantage of that raise as I can to, like, straighten out a couple of things to, like, you know, get, yeah, little thing. And I'm also probably going to be getting a new phone with that, too, because my contract with T-Mobile is coming up, and I'm not renewing with anything. I'm going to go back to no-contract phones because it's a lot more, it's very inexpensive for me, and it's like, you know, a lot more convenient. And actually, a couple of the no-contract phones have a lot better phones now, so I'm very grateful for that. So, but yeah, no cons next month, but August 10th through 12th, I will be at NatsuCon. Of course, I'm there every year. And then September 7th through 9th, I am still on track to take that very, very, very long drive down to New Orleans, Louisiana for MechaCon. So that should be pretty fun too. And then I'm not sure what I'm going to be doing for October. November 2nd through 4th, I might give Anime NebraskaCon a try. That's a huge maybe, so I don't really know for sure if that's going to happen. And then looking at next year, I know I'm going to go ahead on myself, but like next year's going to be pretty awkward for cons because I usually try to take cons whenever it's on my pay weekend, which is a lot more convenient for me because that way I know I have money to spend. But like a couple other cons that I want to go to, like NakaCon for instance, it's off my pay weekend. So that would make it a lot harder for me to get to because usually the week after pay, the week in between paydays, I'm normally out of money. Which, yeah. But, I don't know. We'll have to see what happens there, like, within the next couple of months or so. Because I might be able to make it. I might not. Anime St. Louis next year is going to be off pay week. But that shouldn't be a problem for me. As long as I don't get a room, I should be fine. But, next year, I'm probably going to go for ASIN again. And then we'll see what other cons for next year will be able to work out for me. But, yeah, other than that, I think I'm pretty much done here. So I will just leave you guys with that. See you guys later.